Hello students, welcome to history class. Myself Mrs. Swati Hazare from Gokhale Education Society's HL High School English Medium, Ozhar Township, Nasik. Today we are going to learn history. History of Standard 9th from Maharashtra State Board, English Medium Syllabus, Chapter Number 7, Science and Technology. In this chapter, we shall study India's achievements in the areas of science and technology. Also, we are going to learn about the important institutions in the areas of science and technology and their contribution. Indian Atomic Energy Commission. The Atomic Energy Commission is the governing body of the Department of Atomic Energy, DAE, Government of India. The DAE means Department of Atomic Energy is under the direct charge of the Prime Minister. The Indian Atomic Energy Commission was set up on 10th August 1948 under the late Department of Scientific Research. A resolution passed by the Government of India later replaced the commission by Atomic Energy Commission of India. On 1st March 1958, under the Department of Atomic Energy, with more financial and executive powers, headquarters in Mumbai, Maharashtra. The functions of the Atomic Energy Commission are to organize research in atomic science in the country, to train atomic scientists in the country, to promote nuclear research in Commission's own laboratories in India, to undertake prospecting of atomic minerals in India, and to extract such minerals for use on industrial scale. It has 5 research centers in India: Bhabha Atomic Research Center, BARC, Mumbai; Indira Gandhi Center, Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research, IGCAR, Kalpakkam, Tamil Nadu. Next, Raja Ramanna Center for Advanced Technology, RRCAT, Indore. Variable Energy Cyclotron Center, Kolkata. Atomic Minerals Directorate for Exploration and Research, Hyderabad. Atomic Energy. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru wanted to nurture a scientific temper and bring about the nation's progress. So, he set up Indian Atomic Energy Commission on 10th August 1948 with Dr. Homi Bhabha as its chairman. Its objectives were to produce electricity from atomic energy, to increase the yield of food grains and make them last longer, to set up the technology for achieving this, to develop nanotechnology, and building and operating of research reactors for the production of radioisotopes, building other sources of radiation such as accelerators and lasers, and developing and deploying radiation technology applications in the fields of medicine, agriculture, industry, and basic research. Carrying out and supporting basic research in nuclear energy and related frontier areas of science. Nanotechnology has a vast range of applications such as in medicine, electronics, biomaterials, solar cells, sporting goods, lasers, displays, aerospace, nanofoods, textiles, cosmetics and energy production. Nanotechnology can transform vapors escaping from cars or industrial plants into harmless gases. Department of Atomic Energy was set up in 1956. First nuclear reactor Apsara became functional in 1956. Apsara, we can see here. Apsara is the oldest of India's research reactors. The reactor was designed by the Bhabha Atomic Research Center. Apsara is a light water swimming pool type reactor with a maximum power output of 1 megawatt thermal. The reactor burns enriched uranium in the form of aluminium alloyed curved plates. The experiments including neutron activation analysis, radiation damage studies, forensic research, neutron radiography and shielding experiments. The reactor is also used for research and the production of radioisotopes. India's oldest nuclear research reactor Apsara since 1956. Atomic power station was set up at Tarapur in 1969. The Tarapur Atomic Power Station is located near Boisar in the Thane district of Maharashtra. Began as India's first atomic power project, the Indian government decided to utilize boiling water reactors for the plant. A reactor research center was set up at Kalpakkam. It successfully used thorium for generating atomic power. Originally, it was called as Reactor Research Center, RRC. It was renamed as Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research by the then Prime Minister of India, Rajiv Gandhi, in December 1985. Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research is one of India's premier nuclear research centers. It is the second largest establishment of the Department of Atomic Energy, next to Bhabha Atomic Research Center, located at Kalpakkam, 80 kilometers south of Chennai, India. It was established in 1971 as an exclusive center dedicated to the pursuit of fast reactor science and technology due to the vision of Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. The center is engaged in broad-based multidisciplinary program of scientific research and advanced engineering directed towards the development of fast breeder reactor technology in India. Factories manufacturing heavy water were set up at Vadodara, Talcher, Tuticorin and Kota. Factory at Talcher, factory at Kota. Heavy Water Board, HWB, is a constituent unit under the Department of Atomic Energy in the Government of India. The organization is primarily responsible for production of heavy water, which is used as a moderator and coolant in nuclear power as well as research reactors. India is one of the largest manufacturers of heavy water in the world. The HWB has developed, demonstrated, optimized and deployed the complex production technology of heavy water using monothermal process to produce nuclear grade heavy water. Nuclear grade heavy water is used as a moderator and coolant in pressurized heavy water reactors. India is the largest producer of heavy water in the world and is not only meeting heavy water requirements for the Indian nuclear power program but is also exporting to various countries, then what is the use of heavy water? Heavy water displays similar physical and chemical properties but differs in nuclear properties when compared to ordinary water, which makes it an extremely efficient material for use as moderator and coolant in pressurized heavy water reactor. What is moderator? See, moderator is required in a nuclear reactor to slow down the neutrons produced during the fission reaction so that the chain reaction can be sustained. Heavy water is an excellent moderator. Then what is coolant? Heavy energy produced in the core of reactor due to fission reaction is required to be carried away by a coolant. Heavy water is used as a primary coolant to transport heat generated by the fission reaction to secondary coolant, light water. The light water takes the heat energy from heavy water and generates steam at an appropriate pressure for running steam turbines. Steam turbines drive generators to generate electricity. Research on manufacturing heavy water was entrusted to heavy water projects, later renamed as the Heavy Water Board. Dhruv nuclear reactor. A completely Indian made nuclear reactor called Dhruva was started at Trombay in 1985. The Dhruva nuclear reactor uses uranium as fuel. 350 radioactive substances are produced, which are used in industry, agriculture, and medicine. Dhruva reactor is India's largest nuclear research reactor. It was the first nuclear reactor in Asia proper. Located in the Mumbai suburb of Trombay at the Bhabha Atomic Research Center. Dhruva, in Indian mythology, is a prince blessed to eternal existence and glory as the pole star, means Dhruva Nakshatra in Sanskrit, by Lord Vishnu. It can also mean simply the pole star or ultimate in Sanskrit. Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited, NPCIL. It was set up in 1987 to generate electricity from atomic energy. The objective of the company is to master and develop the technology to generate safe, cheap, and environment-friendly energy. It also aimed to make the country self-sufficient. NPCIL is an Indian public sector undertaking based in Mumbai, Maharashtra. It is wholly owned by the Government of India and is responsible for the generation of nuclear power for electricity. NPCIL is administered by the Department of Atomic Energy. The mission of the company is to develop nuclear power technology and to produce nuclear power as a safe, environmentally profitable power and economically viable source of electrical energy to meet the increasing electricity needs of the country. First nuclear test at Pokhran. India successfully conducted her first nuclear test at Pokhran in Rajasthan on 18th May 1974. The decision to carry out nuclear test was taken by the then Prime Minister Mrs. Indira Gandhi. It was prompted by China acquiring nuclear capability and Pakistan wanting to acquire nuclear weapons with China's help. Dr. Homi Sethna, the chairman of the Indian Atomic Energy Commission, and Dr. Raja Ramanna, director of the Bhabha Atomic Research Center, played a major role in conducting this nuclear test. The location of the nuclear tests, Pokhran, was far away from human settlement and with no groundwater reserves. Smiling Buddha was the assigned code name of India's first successful nuclear bomb test on 18th May 1974. The bomb was detonated on the Army base Pokhran test range in Rajasthan by the Indian Army under the supervision of several key Indian generals. Pokhran 1. Pokhran is a remote location in the Thar desert of Rajasthan Jaisalmer district. With the approval of the then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi, the test range in Pokhran hosted the detonation of India's first nuclear device in 1974. The test was known as peaceful nuclear explosive among the government officials. After the detonation, it came to be known as Operation Smiling Buddha, while the MEA called it Pokhran 1. The Bhabha Atomic Research Center preferred to conduct the test in the remote desert of Rajasthan due to the topography and the weather of the region. The test was conducted during the month of May, when the wind in the region creates a serious sandstorms. The sandstorms obstructs a clear view to American spy satellites. Also, the infrared sensors do not pick up such activity due to the temperature that increases over 50 degrees during the daytime. To maintain the secrecy of the test, the Bhabha Atomic Research Center conducted the nuclear test in Pokhran. After conducting the test, the government announced that it did not intend to manufacture nuclear weapons but just wanted to make India self-reliant in nuclear technology. 24 years after the first test was conducted, the Indian Defence Research and Development Organisation and Atomic Energy Commission conducted 5 more nuclear tests on May 11, 1998. Second nuclear test. At the same location, second nuclear test was carried out on 11th May 1998. To prove its nuclear preparedness. On that day, 3 tests were conducted, one being the hydrogen bomb. Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee assured the world of no first use of nuclear weapons by India. The Pokhran second test were a series of 5 nuclear bomb test explosions conducted by India at the Indian Army's Pokhran test range in May 1998. It was the second instance of nuclear testing conducted by India. The first test, codenamed Smiling Buddha, was conducted in May 1974. The test achieved their main objective of giving India the capability to build fission and thermonuclear weapons with yields up to 200 kilotons. The then chairman of the Indian Atomic Energy Commission described each one of the explosions of Pokhran 2 to be equivalent to several tests carried out by other nuclear weapon states over decades. Pokhran 2 consisted of 5 explosions, the first of which was a fusion bomb, while the remaining 4 were fission bombs. The tests were initiated on 11th May 1998 under the assigned code name Operation Shakti, with the explosion of 1 fusion and 2 fission bombs. On 13th May 1998, two additional fission devices were detonated, and the Indian government, led by Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, shortly convened a press conference to declare India a full-fledged nuclear state. The tests resulted in a variety of sanctions against India by a number of major states, including Japan and the United States. United Nations Security Council Resolution 1172, adopted unanimously on 6th June 1998, after hearing of nuclear tests conducted by India in May 1998. The Council condemned the test and demanded that country refrain from engaging in further tests. Come to the next point, missile development. Under the leadership of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, India started Integrated Guided Missile Development Program to develop several missiles. Name of the missile is Prithvi. First missile tested in 1988. Prithvi 1 was surface-to-surface ballistic missile given to the army. Prithvi 2 was air-to-surface missile given to the Air Force. Prithvi 3 was given to the Navy. It had nuclear capacity to carry 500 to 1000 kilogram nuclear weapons and travel a distance of 150 to 300 kilometer. This is a Prithvi missile. It depends on gravity to reach its target. It's called a ballistic missile. Ballistic missile that fly above the atmosphere have a much longer range than would be possible for cruise missiles of the same size. Ballistic missiles can travel extremely quickly along their flight path. Prithvi 1 class is a single stage liquid fueled surface to surface ballistic missile having a maximum warhead mounting capability of 1000 kilogram with a range of 150 kilometer. It has an accuracy of 10 to 50 meter and can be launched from transporter erector launchers. This class of Prithvi missile was inducted into the Indian Army in 1994. Then Prithvi 2 class is also a single stage liquid fueled missile having a maximum warhead mounting capability of 500 kilogram but with an extended range of 250 kilometer. It was developed with the Indian Air Force being the primary user. Prithvi 3 class is a two-stage surface-to-surface missile. The first stage is solid fueled with a 16 metric ton force thrust motor. The second stage is liquid fueled. The missile can carry a 1000 kilogram warhead to a distance of 350 kilometer and a 500 kilometer warhead to a distance of 600 kilometer and a 250 kilogram warhead up to a distance of 750 kilometer. Next missile, Agni. Agni 1 was developed in 1989, had a range of 700 kilometer. It was developed and tested to give China and Pakistan an idea of India's missile strength and to secure India's borders. Agni 2 and Agni 3 are also developed. Here we can see the Agni missile. The Agni missile is a family of medium of intercontinental range ballistic missiles developed by India, named after one of the five elements of nature. Agni missiles are long-range, nuclear weapons-capable surface-to-surface ballistic missile. The first missile of the series, Agni 1, was developed under the Integrated Guided Missile Development of Program and tested in 1989. Weighing 12 tons, 12 ton with a length of 15 meters. Agniwan has a range of 700 to 900 kilometers and is capable of carrying a conventional payload of 1000 kilogram or a nuclear warhead at a speed of 2.5 kilometers. Agni 2 with a range of 2000 to 2500 kilometers is 20 meters long, has a diameter of 1 meter and weighs around 18 tons. Agni 2 uses solid propellant in both of its two stages. Agni 3 is the third in the Agni series of missiles. Agni 3 uses solid propellant in both stages. Agni 3 has a range of 3500 km and can take a warhead of 1.5 tons. Next missile, Akash. Developed in 1990 to fire from land into air, it had capacity to carry 720 kg explosives at supersonic speed and its range was 30 km. We can see here Akash missile. Akash is a medium range mobile surface to air missile defense system developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization, means DRDO, and produced by Bharat Dynamics Limited for missile systems, Bharat Electronics. The missile system can target aircraft up to 30 km away at altitudes up to 18,000 meter. It has the capability to neutralize aerial targets like fighter jets, cruise missiles and air-to-surface missiles as well as ballistic missiles. It is in operational service with the Indian Army and the Indian Air Force. Akash is a surface-to-air missile with an intercept range of 30 km. It has a launch weight of 720 kg, a diameter of 35 cm and a length of 5.78 meters. Akash flies at supersonic speed, reaching around Mach 2.5. It can reach an altitude of 18 kilometers and can be fired from both tracked and wheeled platforms. Next missile, Nag. It was developed to destroy the enemy tanks with fire and forget technology. The Nag missile, also called Prospina for the land attack version, is an Indian third generation all-weather fire and forget lock-on after launch anti-tank guided missile with an operational range of 500 meter to 20 kilometer. It has a single shot hit probability of 90% and a 10-year maintenance-free shelf life. The Nag has 5 variants under development, a land version for a mass-mounted system. The helicopter-launched Nag, a man-portable version, an air-launched version, which will replace the current imaging infrared to military wave, active radar homing seeker, and the Nag missile carrier tank buster, which is a modified BMP-2 infantry fighting vehicle produced under license in India by Ordnance Factory, Medak. We can see here Nag missile. So students, today we have learnt about nuclear reactor, Nuclear Power Corporation of India, first nuclear test at Pokhran, and about Prithvi, Agni, Akash and Nag missiles. In the second part, we will proceed with space research. So students, thanks for watching.